إن الحمد لله نحمده ونستعينه ونستغفره ونعوذ بالله من شرور أنفسنا ومن سيئات أعمالنا من يهده الله فلا مضل له ومن يضلل فلا هادي له وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له وأشهد أن سيدنا وحبيبنا وعظيمنا وشفيعنا وأسوتنا وقدوتنا ومعلمنا محمدًا عبده ورسوله بلغ الرسالة وأدى الأمانة ونصح للأمة وكشف الله عز وجل به الغمة وجاهد في سبيل دينه حتى آتاه الله اليقين فاللهم اجزه عنا وعن والدينا خير ما جزيت به نبياً عن قومه ورسولاً عن أمته وأوردنا حوضه واسقنا بيديه الشريفتين شربةً هنيئةً مريئةً لا نظمأ بعدها أبداً آمين يا رب العالمين يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله حق تقاته ولا تموتن إلا وأنتم مسلمون يا أيها الناس اتقوا ربكم الذي خلقكم من نفس واحدة وخلق منها زوجها وبث منهما رجالاً كثيراً ونساءاً واتقوا الله الذي تساءلون به والأرحام إن الله كان عليكم رقيبا يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله وقولوا قولا سديدا يصلح لكم أعمالكم ويغفر لكم ذنوبكم ومن يطع الله ورسوله فقد فاز فوزا عظيما أما بعد فإن أصدق الحديث كتاب الله وخير الهدي هدي محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم وشر الأمور محدثاتها وكل محدثة بدعة وكل بدعة ضلالة وكل ضلالة في النار وما قل وكفى خير مما كثر وألها My dear brothers and sisters in Islam, all praises due to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And whoever Allah guides, none can misguide. And whoever Allah permits to misguide, none can guide. We bear witness that there is no God worthy of worship but Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam is his messenger. And the last messenger he sent to mankind to guide them to the right path. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala guide us all to the right path, ya Rabbil Alameen. The most beautiful prophet, the most beautiful soul, our beloved Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala resurrect us with him in Jannah on the Day of Judgment, ya Rabbil Alameen. My dear brothers and sisters in Islam, when it comes to beauty, that you need to be beautiful, to look beautiful, look nice, inside and outside. Our role model is the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. As Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala praised him, and he said, وَإِنَّكَ لَعَلَى خُلُقٍ عَظِيمٍ You are of a high standard of character, O Muhammad, the best manner ever. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala also gave him the most beautiful face. The most beautiful face was given to the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Sometimes we see people like looking nice. I mean, I remember back then, when we used to see people coming for the Friday prayer, looking nice, having tie and a suit, and you say like, you know, why judge a book by its cover? Why do these people judge the book by its cover? And those people might hinder other people from benefiting from the khutba because they look nice, look fancy, like, you know, they attract you, they get your attention. But you know what? Later, we realize that we're wrong. That this ummah, the nation of the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, the ummah of Islam, is the ummah of beauty. Like, usually, people judge the book by its cover. That's why there's that phrase, don't judge the book by its cover. Because it's natural, and it's by default, that people judge the book by its cover. But this phrase tells you, don't always judge the book by its cover. But the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he also told us that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala does not look at your exteriors, your outer shapes, But he looks at your interiors, what you have in your hearts, what you conceal in your hearts. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala knows everything. يَعْلَمُ خَائِنَةَ الْأَعْيُنِ وَمَا تُخْفِي الصُّدُورِ. But subhanAllah, however, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala sent the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam and gave him the most beautiful face. And he came from the purest of the purest of the purest of lineages, our Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Despite that has nothing to do with the religion, that won't draw you closer on the Day of Judgment, won't give you Jannah on the Day of Judgment, but as if Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is telling us, teaching us, even Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, despite Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, although Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala does not care, people care. People like to see a pleasant anything, you know. They like to look a beautiful thing. When they look at the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, they like to hear him out, to hear from him, to learn from him. The Prophet ﷺ told us, "Man batta'a bihi 'amaluhu lam yusri' bihi nasabu." That the one who's slowed down by his actions, your actions are short, you're slowed down by your actions, he's not gonna be brought back up to speed by his lineage, by his family, which means your lineage is not gonna benefit you, your position is not gonna benefit you, your family is not gonna benefit you. The only thing that is going to benefit you is your action. But Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala also sent the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, giving beauty. And he taught us how to be beautiful, because we are the ummah of beauty. To be beautiful in our appearance, in our, you know, how we dress. Because people, sometimes they look at you. If you dress well, they start to interact with you. If you're good, and that's actually part of the religion. And listen to the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam in the hadith. He said, when he was asking about arrogance, "O Messenger of Allah, many of us, they like to look nice." So the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, you know, if you have an atom weight of arrogance in your heart, you won't enter Jannah. But the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, those companions, they were like, you know, people like to dress well. We like to dress well, get new clothes, like comb our hair, color coordinated. We like to do that. We're human beings. And the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam replied or answered the question. He said, "This is not it. This is not what I'm talking about. Inna Allaha jamilun yuhibbul jamal." That Allah is beautiful, and He loves beauty. He loves you to look beautiful. That was the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said. And subhanallah, Anas ibn Malik, he narrated that, or he said, "Ma masastu." Anas ibn Malik, he is the servant of the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. He said, "Ma masastu dibajan wala hariran aliyana min kaffin Rasulillahi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam." That I have never touched a silk or a velvet or whatever, anything that is smoother than the palm of the Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. So Anas ibn Malik is saying that the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam used to look beautiful. Can you please pay attention? So Anas ibn Malik narrated or said that the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam used to look beautiful. His fragrance, he said, that وَمَا شَمَمْتُ رِيحًا أطيب من ريح رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم. That I have never smelled a fragrance or perfume that is more splendid than the perfume or than the smell of the of Rasulullah صلى الله عليه وسلم. How beautiful he looked! Even his smell was splendid, very good smell. Yet that you would love to sit and hang around the Prophet Muhammad صلى الله عليه وسلم. Now this is our deen, this is our religion, this is our role model, the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. When it comes to you, you should be a good follower of the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Look nice, try to work in that. As we said, we're the ummah of beauty. You look beautiful. And the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam used to teach people, Inna Allah jameelun yuhibbul jamal. And even Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in the Quran, when He spoke about the cattle, the animals, the horses, He said in the end, وَالْخَيْلَ وَالْبِغَالَ وَالْحَمِيرَ لِتَرْكَبُوهَا وَزِينَ. That Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has given you al-khayl, the horses, donkeys, all of these things for you to use as means of transportation in the morning and the evening. But in the end, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, وَلَكُمْ فِيهَا جَمَالٌ حِينَ تُرِيحُونَ وَحِينَ تَسْرَحُونَ. That you would be like, you see the beauty of the horses, this majestic animal, that when you see in the morning, a lot of people like, back then they used to ride horses like as if they ride Lamborghini now. It's like horse. And until now, people enjoy riding horses, playing with horses. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala tells us there is beauty in it. You need to be beautiful, because Allah has given us everything that is beautiful. Look at the creation of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala gave us everything that we look beautiful, and we need to work on it. My dear brothers and sisters in Islam, this is number one. A man came to the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, and he was, you know, one of the Bedouin people. He was a shepherd. And he came to the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, looked very shabby clothes. And the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam asked him, what do you do? And he said, I'm a shepherd. You know, he's trying to give excuses, like, you know, I'm in the field all day long, in the land, like dust. You know, I'm a shepherd with sheep, goats. And the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam asked him, and he told him, لِتَظْهَرْ أَثَرُ نِعْمَةِ اللَّهِ عَلَيْكَ. Like, let people see the generosity of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala on you. When Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala blesses you with something, you should let people see that thing that Allah subhanahu has blessed you with. وَأَمَّا بِنِعْمَةِ رَبِّكَ فَحَدِّثْ. Like, speak up about the bounties and the blessing and the gifts of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. That everything Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala gives you, you should tell people about it. Should show the generosity of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has given you, be generous. Tell people about it. And the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, no, don't do that. Some people, they say, you know what? We do it out of, like, you know, we want to feel disconnected from the dunya. But actually, you'll feel more disconnected from the dunya if you tell people about the generosity of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. How is that? Because sometimes you hide the fact that you're disconnected from the dunya, or you show the fact that you're disconnected from the dunya, but you like people to talk about you, to praise you. You know what I'm saying? People say, this guy is not connected to the dunya. He doesn't want anything from this dunya. So people start talking about him. But if you tell people that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is generous with you, you can practice your being disconnected from the dunya. You can be zahid. Then, this is number one. Number two, beauty in your temperament and mood. Number one, your beauty in appearance, how you look. Islam, it's not just okay for that you look nice, but Islam promotes the idea of you looking nice, that you need to be beautiful. It promotes it. Then number two, beauty of temperament, of mood, your mood. Like, what is the vibe that people get when they see you? Are you depressed all the time? You know, I have a hard time, I'm doing this, I need to do this, I don't have a job, and so on. What is it, the vibe that people get when they talk to you? Are they, you know, do they become happy? Or just you put them down? Like, restraining that from people is part of beauty. It's part of being beautiful. When you hide the fact that you have a bad mood, that's part of being beautiful. Now, subhanAllah, you know, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, Ibn al-Qayyim, the student of Ibn Taymiyyah, may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala have mercy on them, Rabbani. Ibn al-Qayyim said, مَا رَأَيْتُ. I never saw or knew a man who is a high-spirited more than his Sheikh Ibn Taymiyyah.